Visar Viška is the first and only ethnic Albanian actor in Macedonia's National Theatre. But he says since he started working here a few years ago, he's been cast only once, and that was for a minor part.
I'm a living subject, that example, that even though I know perfectly Macedonian, better than 99% of Macedonians working in this theater, without accent, without anything, and that knowing Macedonian, speaking Macedonian perfectly, didn't help me at all as an Albanian, right? It was the opposite.
The majority of people who live here in Skopje's old town are ethnic Albanians. They have shops and businesses here, and many signs are written in both Albanian and Macedonian. Albanian is recognized as an official language, but only in areas like this one, where ethnic Albanians make up more than 20% of the population. A parliamentary session to approve the use of Albanian as an official language almost ended in a fight. It still passed, despite efforts by opposition Macedonian nationalists to boycott the vote. But President Gheorghe Ivanov refused to sign it into law.
He's obliged to sign the law and let the institution that's in charge check in if the law is constitutional and valid.
Ivanov's right-wing opposition party, which ruled the country for more than 20 years, says the legislation would put the Balkan countries' national unity in jeopardy.
Unity is built according to the language, because everybody is learning Macedonian language. Now, one ethnicity, will be not obliged to learn a language, Macedonian, and let's say, will avoid learning Macedonian language because it will be not necessary to learn Macedonian language.
Ethnic Albanians make up one quarter of Macedonia's 2.1 million people. The legislation is meant to help them communicate with institutions and to make life easier for people like Visar. He hopes this legislation will finally make Albanians feel Macedonia is their home. Nafisa Latic, TRT World, Skopje.